kaboom. All right, guys. So this is me sans everything. Like, I have not anything on, and I'm put the computer far away so you guys can kind of see a little bit of what's in front of me. Whenever I do my makeup, actually, forget that for a second. Let me just say hello. Good Lord. Where are my manners? Ronnie Robinson is celebrating a 5-month streak. Wow, good for you, Ronnie Robinson. Skelly, hi Dan, and all joining. I'm doing well. All having a great Monday. Hi Terry, cool arrangement. Dr. Mad Hatter just followed. Thanks for following, Dr. Mad Hatter. Okay, so I guess like people will trickle in. So we should wait for just a minute, shouldn't we? Yes, let's. You guys tell me about your day. What happened today for you? I brought my diet root beer to the party. I don't know what you guys brought, but that's what I brought. I bought this brush for Mom when she had long hair. And actually, I bought one for Dakota from my dear friend Steve, who used to do my hair. Anyway, it's like the best brush for like detangling. I cannot even explain it to you, but it's called Wet Brush Pro, and it's like, I don't know, like 15 bucks, I think 20 bucks, but long story short, it is amazing. Like, you can have terrible tangles and it just goes right through them. It's really awesome. Love it. Who all is here? Mr. Hale, Ari, hi, Liam Paul. Hi, Ronnie Robinson. Can my sister get a shout out? Her name is Jenna Tolls. She just got arrested. Huh? Are you being funny, Dr. Mad Hatter? Because if you're being funny, I don't want it tonight. I got too much to do tonight, dude. If you're not being funny, like, if she gets a shout out, how's she going to get it? She's in jail. She's arrested. How's she going to get it? I wouldn't mind giving her a shout out, though. Yeah. Oh, that was really, I saw a little bit of that, Ari. That was really sad. I have like a thought process behind that. Like, anytime that Dustin and I used to fly without Dakota, it used to really scare me because, I used to always think about what if something happened to both of us and then she'll be without a mother or father. And then, like, if it would be just one of us, but anytime the three of us flew together, I always had this peace in my heart because I was like, okay, she's not going to be without a mother and a father, and we'll all go. Sounds morbid, but yeah. So anyway, when Kobe passed with his daughter, part of me thought, you know, that at least she was not alone. She was with him, and he was with her. At least they had each other. But it's so tragic, it's ridiculous, but I'm going to have to do a lot of leaning forward tonight because I have my computer so far away. Hey, who is my mod tonight? Is it Rod, Ari? Who is my mod tonight? Rod, are you my mod? You're so mod, Rod. So mod, Rod. Let me see if I cannot get a little bit of lippy sticky, lippy glossy. Okay, this is one of my favorite things in the whole wide world. Okay, cool. So I have worn this perfume for what feels like the beginning of time. Dustin's sister, Kristen, gave me Michael Kors Leg Shine back in, like, 99, 98, 99, maybe earlier than that. Anyway, I've always worn it. It's his original fragrance. I've always worn it. So, I found out that he actually makes this little dual thing. On one end is, like this very, well, I'll show you. I have nothing on my lips now. I'll show you. It's like a very nude little gloss, and it's just light and lovely. Yeah, see, it's barely anything. And then on the other end is his fragrance and a roller ball. So, like, I can do, like, little behind the ears, little... You're supposed to do it on your pulse points. So, a little on the wrist. and it stays in my purse, and it's just like the most perfect thing. It's like $22, and I like to have at least four or five around me at all times. I just love it so much. So, if you ever want to know what to get me for Christmas, there you go. Michael Kors, original fragrance, and the original little nude thing. Okay. Look who's joining us tonight, guys. What? Ray is with us tonight. Lord knows how many times Ray has watched me put on my makeup while waiting for me to hurry up and get ready so we could go to the airport, the building, the arena, whatever. Bless his bones. Okay, so who else is here now? We'll give him a shot. I mean, you know, he don't want to fill his cigars. Where's AJ? I missed AJ. Where's AJ? Oh, there you are, AJ. Hi, AJ. Okay, so for those of you who don't know, I am a natural redhead, and I have white eyebrows, white eyelashes, like pretty much like all the hair on me is like blonde. But what's weird is if my natural color without the gray comes through, it's like red, right? Copper penny, actually like a dull copper penny red. Anyway. So, I found this thing, I think I found it on Instagram, and it's this, you never know with stuff like that, if it's going to be great or if it's going to suck. Well, this little, cool little thing, hold on, can you see the little light that goes on? On, off, on, off. I need to put new batteries in it. Anyway, it comes with this suction cup, so you put it on a mirror, and then wow, check that out, man. Check you guys out. So it's like this magnifying mirror because, as you guys know, to see anything up close, Mama has to use these, and you can't do your makeup when you have glasses on because you need to get to your face. So I believe this one is a 15X magnification, I believe so. Anyway, so it has this lovely little thing that you can bend and sway and, what was that little character on, there was some movie where a little character was like a little light like this or something. I don't know. Never mind. Forget that. So anyway, yeah, you suction cup it, you twist it, and it locks it in place, and I love it. So I will be using this, if you wonder what I'm looking down at, it's this in my lap, or up here. Okay, guys, look at this little thing that happened. So, Rodney Robinson, you and I were worried about me sleeping last night because of me drinking the coffee with caffeine as opposed to the decaf coffee I was supposed to drink. So, I end up falling asleep reading with my glasses on. Woke up in the middle of the night with them on. Like, literally, I'm sleeping and my glasses are on. So, but what happened was, I've got this little, like, it's like I made my nose angry, like right there. It's all angry and like hurt and bruised and upset with me and stuff like that. So, you guys, I was concerned as well. I'll try. What? Drum roll. The Martin Duggan is here. The Martin Duggan, the one that sat in this very chair with me last time. Martin, were we at the table or were we in the bed last time? Or on the couch last time? Where were we? I don't remember. Anyway, Martin joins us tonight. I don't know for how long. I hope for as long as possible. You guys, it's gonna be hard for me to not be able to read, but I can't put my glasses on once I kind of get started with my face anyway. All right. So this is a get ready with me. Excuse me, my goodness, the root beer. I'm going to put Ray over here to the side. He's always watching. Wait, I have a question for you guys. So I have the pop-up chat over here. I can see it over here. Can you guys see Ray? Like, is he in frame for you guys? Or is it cut off because he's cut off from where I can see? Can you guys tell me? Bedroom and the table. Did we not ever do the couch? I guess we didn't. Night, Mama. By the way, guys, Gingy is feeling better. Hi, Dub Love. Okay, so you guys can see this far. Okay, great. I can't. It's literally, it's blocked from here from there over, I can't see in the frame. So, okay. So, should I start yet? I'm gonna start. So you guys see me 9 times out of 10 with my smoke and mirrors all on, and like you've never seen me in the ring or going to the ring looking like this, right? And normally, from the neck down, I would be very tan, and then I would have to mix a formulation of foundation here to match the rest of my body. You need me? I'll do it. Do you want to do it, or do you want me to do it? Okay, well then, so you want me to do it? Okay, well all you have to do is just ask. I was planning on it anyway, but just ask and I'll take care of it. So, any hoodle doodles, where was I? Mark, where was I? Yes, right. Oops. All right, so normally it would be totally white face and then tan body. But I haven't been tanning like since last year. My OneDrive is full. I can't help it right now. Sorry. Lord, sweet Jesus, help me. Okay. Because my skin, like my face and the rest of my body is the same color, I won't have to worry about that tonight. So, you guys know this going in for a while. I'm not going to be able to see you because the computer is so far away. And I just can't see what... I can see that you're writing stuff, but I can't see what it says. So, don't ask me any questions right now. Hold off on them. Write them down if you have them, but... Okay, so normally what I like to do is, because I do such a dark eye because of my little white eyelashes and eyebrows and everything, I like to do my eyes first. And that way, any of the black fallout, doesn't get on my foundation and make my eyes look like I'm a raccoon or something. So, I'm going to start with that first. And I am going to scoot you guys in a little bit so you can see more of what I'm doing. Should I show you this really quickly? So I have things segmented into different categories, okay? So I always put a towel down and then paper towels on top of the towel. And that way it gives me kind of a cushy backdrop, but yet I can clean my brushes as I go. So put that over there. Normally I use a... help me. Oh my God, I can't believe I'm like... Primer! Normally I use a primer, but I don't think I'm going to tonight because I'm just going to wash my face off, so I don't need to worry about it lasting very long. So we're going to get started. The first thing that I like to do is lay down a really neutral color on my eyes, almost like... if you have a translucent powder. So I'm actually using a translucent powder to do that very thing. So all of my brushes that are to the right, normally the sink would be to my left. And so everything going to the right starts out with anything that is inside of a tube or something that if water splashed on it, it wouldn't get on a brush and ruin a brush. So everything over here is not going to get damaged if water splashes on it. That's why that section is closest to the basin of the sink. The next section is brushes that I use for dark colors. The next section is what I use for nose contour and highlighter. The next section is kind of a generic who's who of brushes, a medium color, light color. For instance, on this brush, and I'm not going to take the time to tell you the name of the brushes and the numbers of the brushes, because I'll take long enough just yapping tonight. But on this end, and you guys can figure it out yourselves and write your own thing on there. Sometimes I'll coat it by putting a color fingernail polish on it, and that will let me know, okay, Anything that has a red stripe of fingernail polish on it is for dark colors. Anything, you know, I just code it in different ways. This one, I didn't have to code. On this end, it's to buff out any dark colors. And on this end, it's to buff out any light or warm colors. Dark, cool, warm, light. Okay. So, what we're going to do is we're going to start out with this little brush. And I'm going to use the lid of my... This is just Bare Minerals Mineral Veil. And I actually like it. It's a really translucent little number. Okay. So, I'm going to try to make it where you guys can still see what I'm doing. And I can see what I'm doing. You guys see? Yes? No, maybe? All right. So, I don't know. I'm going to have to hold it down here, guys. All right. So, all over my lid, I'm putting the mineral veil. Okay? Just because before that, I put on my trusty Oil of Olay. I've worn it since, like, I was little. My grandmother, sensitive skin, Oil of Olay Complete with SPF 15. And then as of late, after I wash my face with Dove Sensitive Skin, I use this serum. And then I use the Oil of Olay. So that's already on my face. Okay? So, and guys, if you are like a guy that's never sat to watch his girlfriend do her makeup, she's probably like naturally beautiful and doesn't have to go through all the hell that I have to go through. But if you've never sat through it, this would be a good thing for you to sit through just to know what the heck we go through, either for you guys or for work or for whatever. So, okay, again, I'm just applying this all over the lid. I do not use an eyeshadow primer. I don't like the way they look on me at all. This brush is to flick away any fallout of any kind, dark, light, whatever. And then I hit it against the towel. Okay, so even though tonight I'm wearing a black and white outfit, normally I would wear probably black and gray, black and silver. I want to do a warm color tonight, which is not what I would, like I said, normally would wear with this. But we're going to do that tonight. We're going to do a little bit more of an earthy color. So, let's see. Ray, you got to move, baby boy. You got to sit over here for a second. You watch the people. You sit right there and watch the people. Okay. So this is a thirsty, by the way, I left some of my stuff in Minnesota. Shout out to Molly for shipping it back to me. So I don't have everything of mine, but anyway. So this is a thirsty palette from Jeffree Star. And you can see I've used the metallics like crazy. But we're going to use this one little color right here. Again, I'm not putting my glasses on and off to read the names or anything else. I'm just going to work. So we're going to use this little jobby, this little number, and we're going to lay this in the crease so we can make, we want it, Mom, is that you? Somebody in the living room? I'm going to see if this will work better if I hold this, guys. I think this will work better. Okay, so I'm just going to kind of lay this in the crease of my eye so that it gives it some depth, and when you get older your skin starts to look not good right there in that very section. So we're just starting out gently and easily. Mom, are you in there? What is that noise I'm hearing? You're freaking me out. Okay. See, this is when most everyone that does a Get Ready With Me video, they edit it. We're not editing, guys. This is live and in living color. It's just the way it's going to be. Doodly-doo, screwly-screw. Okay, so you can see just like I've put a little depth into right there under the grab-on, okay? No big deal, no big whoop. It's all good. It's all okay. I'm going to take a little bit of this color. I don't know what it is. It's like an earthy brown. It's like that color. You see, I've hit pan a long time ago. What does it mean when you say you've hit pan? If you've hit pan, that means, see that little silver section right there? You hit the bottom of the pan. You're scraping the leftovers. That's what that means. Sometimes, if you don't buy two or three of a color and you love that color, they go out of production and then you can't get them anymore. And you still love them, so you still use them anyway, even though you shouldn't be using them any longer. Do you guys want me to use this or no? Yeah, we'll use this. All right, so I'm going to deepen it now with that color. So you guys can start to see how it builds up. Wait, I see a diamond. Jump 5, thank you. It's funny, I can't see what you guys are writing, but I sure can see those donations coming up. What? Yeah. Fire, baby. Fire. We are fire tonight. Okay, see the difference? See the difference? See the difference? Okay, I'm going to work on this little bone and corner. This is so funny. I'm so working backward looking at myself in this video. It's so weird. Weird, I tell you, it's weird. Do we need some, like, background music? Should we get Gingy in here to sing or something? What should we do? Okay, I'm going to bring this in a little bit more since I brought the other one in a little bit more. Ooh, wait, no, this eye, yeah, this eye. All right, but you guys see, like, the difference when you don't have the dark and the bone right there, what happens? Like, it fades away. Okay, so now we're going to blur out the edges with the warm end of this brush. I'm going to try to, as much as I can, not look in the mirror and try to do it from far away. Okay, so just blur that little edge out. And I have to use a mirror on this one. Hold on. Blur that little edge out. Okay. Then, as you guys saw, I take, anytime I use a brush, I go ahead and I just wipe it on the paper towel and scrub it so that when I throw it back in my bag, the dark shadow doesn't fall all over the light. And anyway, let me see if I can read what you guys are saying so far. I'll try to stop every so often and see what you guys are saying. Okay. Welcome to Stream Toucan. We have someone named Toucan? Really? I love it when you guys say hello to each other. Hey, Mr. Duggan. Hi, Rodney. Hi, Terry Nation. Hi. Hi, everyone. I love it. Love it so much. Okay, I don't know what accent I was just doing, but anyway, silly. I usually have either a antibacterial wipe or a wet paper towel, or if I'm in a hotel, a wet bath cloth, just to, like, if I need to just touch some little thing and get it off my fingers, I can do that. Remember last night. Remember this, guys. Remember this. Sorry, Ray. I didn't mean to knock you over, baby boy. Gosh, it's happening again. All right. Enough of that. Enough of that. Did I tell you guys I lay all my tools in the upper left-hand corner? So, like, Q-tips. This was first introduced to me by Peter Fonda ages ago when I worked for Larry King Live. So this, like, when you have, like, lumpy lashes or whatever, this comb goes through them and separates them. And then I've got all kinds of other little tools here. We'll work with that later. All right, so we've got a little bit of depth going on here, some foreground and some background on the eyeballs, right? Right, right, dear. That's great. All right, so let's do this. Let's take... This is a frost, and normally frosts don't do well on older women because it basically kind of shows your wrinkles. But, well, here we go. Okay, so I'm just going to do a little up on the brow bone right here. I think that color is mushroom. I'm not sure. But every time I pick it up, that's the color I think it is. So that's just the color I'm making it tonight. All right, so... And again, I'm just pulling it up on my brow bone a little bit, okay? For guys that I'm doing a full-on, like if I was doing an appearance makeup tonight, this is not going to be like a natural look or anything like that. This is going to be like very, this is appearance-ready kind of look that I'm doing tonight. So if you like your woman natural or if you like me natural or whatever, tonight is not your night, but it is your night to see what all we go through. Okay, so now I always have a stack of Q-tips over here, or I like to call them Q-tips. I don't know why I say that to myself. Where are my Q-tips? Q-tips, where are the Q-tips? So yeah, so I can like go ahead and give myself a little solid line there. Okay, anything dirty goes to the right. Have a little throwaway bin. Okay, so what we're going to do next, because remember the reason we're doing our eyes first, or my eyes first, is so we don't get fallout on the actual foundation. Not be good. Not be good. So now we're going to take a brush that is, I only use it for dark colors. You can see this is black. And once again, I have hit pan. Let's see. Wait, what are y'all agreeing about? Aww, that's really nice. Yes, AJ, I met Peter. You would not believe the people I met. I almost said the Peter I met. You would not believe the people I met doing Larry King Live for all those years. I shouldn't say all those years because I didn't do it all those years. Remember, I was assaulted twice and I said, I'm out of here. I'm gone. Moving on up. Okay, so I'm twirling around in my little... Like, this is a flat black. There's no frost to it. It is like charcoal black. Okay? This is going to really make it look different. Actually, oh, hold on. I want to do a little, let's go back with a little mushroom color and do that on the lid. Let's do that really fast. Shall we? I'm going to use a brush that will lay down some color pretty nicely. Let's see here. Always tap off your excess into your pan or whatever it is. Okay, yeah. We're going to put just a little of the mushroom right there. Hello, mushroom. Hello, Moto. Where's Jinjin tonight? She's the one that told me I had to do this tonight. Shouldn't say I had to do it, but she gave me the idea to do it, right? All right, so this is on my lid, right? Like, butt up to my eyelashes, okay? So, there's that there. Okay, sometimes I blow to get the excess off. Sometimes I use this to get the excess off. Okay. All jokes, please leave at the front desk. Okay, so, now we're going to go in with that black color. That really, really, really black color. All right, this is where the fallout, when it hits my face, I'll show you in just a second. Okay, so we're going to go into... the crease, and we're going to really make sure that we deepen that crease so that you can see the difference. You know what you guys can do while I'm doing this, since I can't read what, like, you guys can talk amongst yourselves. That would make me feel better, because then y'all aren't sitting here bored to death, like waiting for me to do the next thing or whatever. Because I really do actually feel bad for you guys, because it's kind of like, well, how's this helping us? But I'm telling you, if you have a girlfriend or a wife, after watching this, you'll be so empathetic. You'll be like, honey, look at all you go through for me. Thank you so much. I love you. Okay, so now that we've taken this and we've gone into that, or in the crease underneath the brow bone, okay, we've done that. Now we're going to take the cool and dark end of this little brush, and we're going to buff out the edges. So we're going to do like this. I'm going to do it on this side. This is kind of, okay, I'm going to take my hand and rub like this, and you'll see, can you guys see? Like, see all in there, like, see all the dark shadow where it dropped down and fell? See? I do, however, have a, where is it? I thought I had a makeup wipe in here. Where's my assistant? I need an assistant. Dagnabbit. Okay, I don't. So now, But you see what I just pulled from under my eye, right? That dark. So you don't ever, ever, ever want to have that be put down on top of your foundation, because then you look like you have two black eyes underneath, right? Let me do the other one, and then I will clean off and then re-moisturize underneath my eyeballs really fast. Okay. See, again, like every time someone does a get ready with me video, like usually what they'll do is they'll do one eye and then go off screen and do the other eye and then pop back on, and it makes it go so much faster. But we're just going to have to talk amongst ourselves and find ways to liven this little sucker up. Is that all right with you guys? Here's what I need. Mart. This is perfect. Are you still on Mart? Martin Duggan. Martin Duggan. Duggan. Martin Duggan. Okay. But guys, is Mart still on? My idea is this. That while I'm doing my makeup and I can't read what you're saying, Martin can call me and he can say, okay, Tara, so-and-so is asking so-and-so. And then I can answer it. And then that makes it go faster. Don't call me boss in front of people. That's our private joke. Come on now. All right, so let's do it. Mar, are you cool with doing that, babe? I don't know who. Ronnie, see who that person is. I don't know who that is. I don't know what they're talking about. Okay, Martin Duggan. Hey. Do you guys hear the little baby chickens? Okay, Mark, I'm calling you. Ready? Duggan, Martin Duggan, Martin Duggan. Okay. Where's my little Mart? Where did you go, Martin? There you are. All right, audio only. Don't call me boss in front of people. But he does it all the time, and it's like, I used to like ask him to not do it because it embarrassed me. I'm like, dude. But he still did it anyway. So that goes to show you what kind of a boss I am, right? I'm not a boss. Although Dakota did tell me the other day, Mom, he's a bossy. Sorry. I'll do better. I'm calling. He's not answering. Yo, Duggan. Not reachable. Martin. You're just talking to me, babe. It's just you and me. You and I. I forget what it's called. Liam, if he doesn't answer, I'm going to have to call you and get you to do it. But I think that would be better. Don't you guys think that would be better? Wait, I'm supposed to be... Okay, so now on this one, we're going to buff this sucker out. What are you doing? Who are you saying that to? Ari, me? Maybe chill. Okay, so I'm buffing that down there, and then I'm going to buff up here. Need the brow bone. Buff away. Buff. All right, is Martin like leaving me? All right, Liam, are you on deck? Liam, are you on deck? And do you have, like, are you staying with me all night? If so, we got some work to do. Do I have, see how much like dark, let's see, can you even see, or is it too like bright for you to see? Anyway, I'm staying. All right, I'm just going to call you Liam, because I don't know where the heck Mara went. Is that okay if I do that, Liam? And you can read and tell me what I need to answer audibly. Yes, no, maybe. It is so warm in this house. I don't know. I'll just keep putting on makeup. So I think that at this point, okay, all right, cool. calling Liam. Oh, God, please let me understand your accent and you mine. Surely we can do that. Oh, no. Listen to the delay.
No, it's fine. Don't worry.
No, it, what? Shoot. This is not going to work.
No, it's what?
It'll drive us crazy. We can't do it.
Yeah, it's... If I turn down my... I can hear you then.
Okay, and you can still read what they're saying. And tell me, and say, so-and-so asked so-and-so, right?
Yeah, cool.
Right,
I'll just turn down my sound.
If you'll do that, and you can hear me here, if you'll do that, and then that way I can, I mean, we can do more than just them staring at me doing my face. Is that cool?
Yeah, cool.
Okay, can you hear me fine, though? Audio's good for you?
Yeah, the audio's perfect.
Perfectione. Okay. All right, so we're at the point of... Oh, it looks like I need to buff this other sucker out a little bit more, like over here. Which one looks like it needs buffing more, this one or this one?
The right one.
This one? This one?
Yeah.
Is Johnny with you?
He's asleep.
Johnny or Jimmy? I got the name wrong.
It's Jimmy. Jimmy.
It's Jimmy, yeah, Jimmy. He's sleeping through this? Really? Darn it.
Sorry?
I said he's sleeping through this? Darn it.
I know. He goes to bed at like 9 a.m. or 9 p.m.
That's like my friend Luke. He goes to bed at these crazy hours. Like 8:30, 9 o'clock. I call him Grandpa.
Jimmy's a grandpa.
He's a grandpa too. Okay. So,
guys, any questions?
Yeah, any questions? Liam's going to ask whatever your questions are to me, and then I'll answer them. So, right now, I've already said that I'm not going to do a primer tonight. I'm just going to do my foundation. And I said that normally I would have to mix and match foundation colors to match the rest of my skin, but I don't because I have a tan. So... But I'm going to show you one thing about how I do, because I take pictures and I wear a little bit of a darker face because I don't want to have a white face when I take a lot of pictures. So I do a little bit darker face than normal. I've started just for speed's sake using my, now that wouldn't that be nice to get all over my foundation? See? Mm-mm. That's not going to work. You know what I'm going to go do? I'm going to go get one of my little makeup towelettes, and I'll be right back. Talk amongst yourselves, and I will be right back. Oh my gosh. My mirror just fell off. I could just use this as a fairy wand or something, or a microphone. It's going to be my microphone for the rest of the night. When I sing goodbye to you guys, I'm using this tonight. And then I'll just hold this in my hands. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, I don't know if you guys have Neutrogena wipes over there, but they're my favorite wipes. Do you guys have these makeup wipes? These? Yes, no?
So, AJ is asking a question.
Okay.
How long has this been your routine?
Again, this is just a, this is an appearance routine. So this is not what I would do every day at all. So routine, and also like my colors and my things change depending upon exactly what I'm going to, if I'm going to a wedding, a funeral, an appearance, whatever. My hair's going to drive me crazy now. Okay. So clean hands. I'm going to put the liquid foundation into my hand. I'll show you. And then I'm going to rub together. And I always touch a little bit right here so I have some left. And then The reason I started doing this is totally, totally for speed. Because I can get this done so much quicker.
Skelly Shu is wondering how much of what you do with your makeup is from your experience as a professional makeup artist?
Pretty much everything.
Everything. Yeah. That's what I was asking you earlier. Like,
yeah.
I see Jimmy has to go across the UK every couple of years to kind of upskill.
Yeah.
Like, so what's changed? Has it changed a lot for you since the 80s and the 90s?
So, of course it has, because there's a much more, back in the 80s and 90s, like, there was nothing natural about anything we did in makeup. It was god-awful, right? I mean, our hair was, like, 4 feet tall, and our makeup was loud and proud, and, it was just kind of nutty. Okay, dampened sponge I'm taking just to go on the edges and get off any excess. And I've got to, you guys, that little place where my glasses made my nose mad. I'm going to cover that in a minute. Anyway, so now what I can see even without having a close-up mirror is that I need a little bit more to blend into my neck. And then I'll show you how I'm going to take care of the other in a second. Okay, now then.
Do you ever look at pictures from old makeup and just cringe?
Oh, yeah. Like, I used to do makeup for Bobby Batista at CNN Center in Atlanta. Whew, bless her heart. Like, oh, Lord. I'm trying to think who else was there at that time. I mean, it was just like, are you serious? Like, you look today and you're just, it's hilarious, actually. It's scary and it's hilarious. Where's my hair? Hi. There we go. We're just going to put this back for a moment. Okay. I need to look for a second. Okay. So, I've just gotten the basics down, so I don't have a white. Now, right here, you guys, I burnt my skin with a curling iron accidentally last night. So that is going to probably, I can change the color, but it will still be raised a little bit. Okay, this is not my normal concealer at all, but this was an emergency one that I had to go out and grab while I wait for mine to be shipped from Molly. So, like, for instance, we'll do the nose right here for a second. Okay, this little thing has a sponge on it, but I wouldn't, like, leave it with that. I would do my own little sponge. And then another thing I like to do is use a brush. So, like, for instance, take a brush on the end of the sponge and then go in and pat until that little sucker is gone. Then I've got these little red, like, I call them heat bumps all over my face, especially like in this zone here. And so I definitely have to lighten and whiten those. So let me show you how I do that really quickly. What a freaking freckin' mess I have, man. I love you. Any more questions while I'm like piddling about?
There's one from Arizona who's saying, Terry, can I talk to you another day when I have time? I don't know what that means.
Yeah, of course. Okay, so in makeup, anything that recedes that you want to pull out, like dark circles or pockets of the eyes, or like right here is very receded on me, right in here is very, it's recessive. So I take a lighter color and pull that out. And then where I want a color to kind of go in, basically, I use a darker color. So here's with the light color. And again, I just bought this little thing. I have no idea how it's going to work. We'll see. Kathy, I'm going to go back to my sponge, not my brush. Hold on. All right, so a little bit around the nose. But can you see the difference in, like, the lightness that's pulled out here? that kind of makes it look not so like it's receding. Yes, no, maybe.
Yeah, that's
right. All right. We'll put it on with this. Let's see. No, I'm just going to blob it on with this and do it. Yeah, so this, you guys can tell this is definitely not my routine because I don't have my stuff with me, but, or not all of my stuff with me. Okay. So around the nose, she goes. All right. Then I want to take a line right down the center of my nose. Okay, and we're going to buff that in with our sponge. And all that's going to do is just make the contour that I'm going to put on the sides of my nose pop out more. And we're going to make this right here because my eyes are kind of close set. We're going to make that pop out a little bit more there. Okay. Got that going there. And we're going to use the brush for that one because I want to be able to get in the little nooks and crannies of beside the nose right there. And then as I work up there, then I can go back to the spongy. And this is called stippling. I don't know what they call it today, but it's stippling. Okay, so next thing is under my eyes. So I don't want to look like a raccoon, but I do want to pull out the dark under, like, sunken areas of my eyes. Before I do that, I see a little bit of the black eyeshadow in the corners of my eyes. So I want to get that out of there so that it does not make a big fat mess. And so we're going to do kind of like a little V here. Like that little V. And then we can take the brush and lightly buff that out. And then on the edges, I'm going to take those and buff those into my cheek. Are we having questions or no? Because I'm not looking. Liam.
There's no questions yet.
Are they just going, what the hell are we doing? What are we doing? Okay, again, I'm going to do like a little, God, it's so hard to look into this and do, I'm supposed to be using the little ones, right?
So, Skelly Chu is asking, when you do the full makeup routine, your appearance, how long does it take?
Oh, like, when I have all my stuff and it's out, I can slap the stuff on in like a good 35, 45 minutes. That's if I'm hurrying. If I'm not hurrying, I like to take an hour just because I don't want to rush. I'd like to, you know, sit there and enjoy my time putting on my makeup instead of rushing through it. See, this stuff I have never used before. And it's kind of drying before I can get to it to stipple it in. So it's kind of looking a little too white and opaque for me. But it is what it is. That's what we got for tonight, guys. All right, so now then, we're just going to take a little, like, all this does is, like, diffuse your edges. Like, if you've ever been around me during an appearance and I ask you to please put the flash on, the reason I ask people to do that is because it diffuses wrinkles, but it also brightens up the eye area and the nose area. Otherwise, it's very shadowy. And there it goes. And so it's just very difficult to have a really nice picture without it. And it's so funny. People will say to me, they're like, oh, no, it doesn't need it. It's on auto. If it needs a flash, it'll flash. And I'm like going, no, it may not need it, but I need it. I need the flash. All right, so right now I'm going over with a translucent powder, and I'm basically just giving it the old 1-2, setting it. I'm not baking. I'm not doing any of that. I'm just doing a quick set, which just means that all of the makeup that I just put on, now that this powder is on, will allow me to then drag a powder, contour powder on without making a huge mess. So
AJ's asking you, did you ever get your makeup done by Jeanette during the WWE career?
So, because I was a makeup artist, I liked the way I did my makeup. And so, I would have her sometimes help me with hair, but normally not my face.
And he's also asking, did you ever share tips with her?
No, we were all so busy, and like either we were laughing or we were all busy and running around like chickens with our head cut off. At least we were back in the day. Okay, guys, so I'm going to do a contour around my face and on my cheeks. So it's kind of a little bit of a drag contour that I do because I'm getting older. The O word, not that O word, but that O word, older. Okay, so I'm going to cut in on my cheekbone, and then I'm going to cut in on my neck. Just watch. You'll see. You'll see. Okay. And I actually, for some reason, got used to using Benefit's Hoola Brush, which I'm using right here. And I don't know what, now it's like I'm just used to using it, so I don't use a different brush now. And I just carry that into the cheek area. I mean, into the hairline area. God, I cannot see for diddly. Okay, so then I go right here, and then I go right here to cut in my neck and chin area. Isn't this fun? You know,
what's your favorite thing to do on your face?
I was just about to say, like, so many people like have fun doing makeup. I'm to the point where after all these years, I'm like, I don't want to do my makeup. I just want to get ready and go. Okay, so again, right here, I'm going to cut in and kind of meet up here, meets down here, and then cuts my jaw. And then we just kind of fade that into the neck. But here's my magic trick. Okay, then I take this brush, this little angled brush. I use just a smidgen of Hoola on it, and I kind of diffuse that hard line up top so it's not quite so harsh. I'm so going the wrong ways. This is hilarious. No, that way, that way, that way. Oh my gosh, this is too funny. It's really not funny, but anyway. All right, and then I usually take up here at the top of my head and do a little, like, add a little color up here. Okay, then I take this little brush that was probably meant for eyeshadow, and remember how I did the little white line down my nose? Now I'm going to use the same Hoola contour that I just cut my cheeks and jaw with, and I'm going to cut my nose, which sounds funny. Actually, look at what I just found. Mama left a little of that red nose thing on there. What am I, Rudolph now or something? Hold on. See, guys, see right there? It's driving me insane. Hold on. Go away. Read some books.
John is asking, do you think men should wear makeup?
I believe that there, okay, like, I know anyone that's redheaded, like, has barely any eyelash color, and that really is, something I think is important. Like, otherwise, like, you see how weak my eyes look without anything on them? They just look weak. I think that it's not bad if a guy uses, like, a little bit of mascara or some foundation or some, concealer, but I think the whole thing is you've got to be confident wearing it, otherwise you're going to feel like a fruitcake, and you're going to come off like a fruitcake, and you don't want to do that.
Yeah.
You want to come off as confident, so I don't mind if a guy wears makeup. I think there are cases where they get a little crazy, but I don't mind if a heterosexual, if you're asking like a heterosexual male, is that what John's asking, or no? Or just any male,
I just think, do you think men should wear makeup? Well, I wear concealer if I have spots, or I wear a moisturizer, or a BB cream.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm milk bottle white, so I have to wear tinted moisturizer.
Right. Yeah, and I mean, but like, I guess everything has a, you know, there are variables to everything. So guys, again, I'm just taking this in here and running it down the side of my nose. And then at the very tip of my nose, I will do this, if I can see it properly. I do this at the very tip to kind of like push that in a little bit. Okay. Then I'm going to brush off some of the excess and then just kind of buffer all that in. Okay. This still looks like it needs to be diffused a little bit. All right, now, here's my magic trick, and it involves Michael Kors again. Michael Kors is my lover, even though he's gay, he's my lover. Okay, so this is a Michael Kors bronzing powder. Now, not only is it a bronzing powder, but it smells just like the perfume. So when I am home, I utilize this glass jar, and I think I have like three of these. Like I want to die before I run out of these. Anyway, so what I do is I take and dip a little in there and in the lid of the powder. Dust off a little bit. Hold on. All right, and then usually I start with right here and go down, and then work my neck in. Into my ear a little bit, into my ear a little bit. And then depending upon what I'm wearing, right? So like, for instance, if I'm wearing this, then I will, let me show you a little trick here so you don't get makeup everywhere. So you take whatever you're wearing, if it is a high neck thing or low neck, whatever it is, and then you just cover yourself that way. You can then come down here and hit all of this without getting it all over your clothes. Okay? You guys see that? Then you just pop those suckers out. And there's that. Okay? Now, if I'm traveling, I take this little sucker with me, which I put some Michael Kors powder in, and this goes with me as my, because I don't want to travel with something that heavy or that big or whatever. So, yeah. Anyway. So, the other thing. Oh, shoot, I didn't finish. Okay, so then I take and basically I give myself a little cheat right here. I go over my forehead a little bit, hit my nose, chin again, and then that's done. Okay, that's all done. Then I take my powder brush and just kind of diffuse that again. Okay. Now, here's a trick that I learned from Scott Barnes. Okay. So, you saw that I just did, like, the bronzer to go on down my, you know, décolletage. That's what that's called, gentlemen, in case you didn't know. Décolletage. So, if you take Neutrogena's 45 or 100, it doesn't matter what SPF. But if you spray it, I'm going to try to do this without making a huge mess. Wait, I got to look. Hold on, guys. Shazam, I can't see. Okay, if you spray that on, and then you take your highlighter, and you dust it along your...
I will say, like, all this cool packaging makes makeup appealing.
It does, doesn't it? Oh my gosh, see? I'm going at the wrong angle. Hold on. I can't see to do it right. Hold on. Oh my lord. Where's my collarbone? Where is my collarbone? Anyway, you put that on and then you put this, you just touch that on the top of your collarbone, right? And it makes your collarbone pop out and look really pretty. And people are going like, you botched that, Terry. I think I did botch that. Let's put my necklace back around front. Because we like that necklace. Okay. Now then, we have to go back up to the eyes. So let's get some of this out of the way, because we're not messing with it anymore. We'll do a highlight on the cheek. Hold on, we'll do a highlight right here. See? I'm supposed to be going this way. I can't do that. Why can't I do it on that side especially? Okay, alright, there we go. Alright, let's hop back up to eyes. Oh, my nose is itching. Alright, back up to eyes. So, we have no liner on now. Here's what we're going to do for our liner.
They go. Jake, you just joined and is saying, yay, a makeup tutorial.
You are almost done. We are almost done. I gotta put moisture back on my lips. Were you guys here when I said this is my, like, my Michael Kors that I've worn ever since Dustin's sister got it for me in the leg shine? And I, like, for like 15 years I've worn this. This is the Michael Kors powdered bronzer that I can't live without. And this is the Michael Kors, like, little duo thing. On one end is the original perfume. On the other is this, like, nude gloss that I, is to die for. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to go back up. Why is my nose itching? We're going to go back up with a pencil liner, and then we're going to smudge it with this little jobby. Derek and Jakey, we're not taking time tonight to talk about colors, brush numbers, anything like that, because it's not an edited photo, so a video. So we want to hurry. All right, so you guys, I'll try to do it and then move and let you see what I'm doing. So.
John 5 is asking, can you use horsehair because of your allergy to horses?
Can I use what?
Can you use horsehair because of your allergy to horses?
No.
Horses?
No. No way, Jose. Okay, so basically I got the liner laid down and I just want to smudge really fast before it dries. And again, you don't want in this look, I don't want a harsh line. I just want to buff it out and make it look kind of smoky. And I think what I'm going to do under my eye is that same mushroom color for like an under eye smoke out.
Derek J. Tiefus asked, have you ever used Laura Mercier?
Laura Mercier, yeah. Yes.
Makes the best tint moisturizer.
Yes. Yes, she does. Do you guys like to see, like, just right now, this is with it, no mascara, no under eye anything, just the liner. Like, do you see how, like, it's starting to come together? It's crazy. It's crazy, crazy.
It looks good.
Well, at least it's starting to look like the person you guys know, right? Derek and Jakey, I brought out my gold necklace for everyone to see tonight. I haven't pulled it out yet, though. I will in a minute. Can you guys hear the little bitties in here? Do you hear the little chickens or no?
Okay. I can't hear any chickens.
You can't? That's so funny. No. That's so funny. They're driving me crazy.
Well, I think it's thunder in here, I think.
Yeah?
I think I heard thunder.
wait, Liam, what town are you in again?
Time?
What town? What town are you in?
Oh, town? It's a small town called Ennis in County Clare in Ireland.
Spell it.
Ennis.
Ennis?
Yes.
Okay.
It's a really cute small town.
So how far away are you from? How long will it take me to get to you from Scotland?
You'd have to get a plane to Shannon or Dublin.
I can't, like, go in any other way. I have to go by a plane.
Yeah, She can't get here by land. It's not connected.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Stop it. I didn't know that, yeah. Dude. I had no idea. Okay, really quickly, guys. Because I have blue eyes, sometimes I accent that. And sometimes I put black on my waterline. But today I'm going to do blue on my waterline. So, let's see if I can let you guys see this. So, can you see what I'm doing? And don't ask me why you have to open your mouth when you do this. I have no idea. And what I like to do is ever so slightly get the pencil onto the edge of my lashes themselves, right? And then do the other side really fast. Hold on.
So John Fife says you're still very pretty with or without makeup. Winky face.
Thank you, John. It's awfully kind of you, sir. Awfully, awfully kind of you. Okay. Now then, I'm not going to do a black liner underneath my eyes on the bottom. I'm going to simply use that mushroom color eyeshadow and make it really smoky looking. If I can find my little smoky looking brush, where's that? Excuse me. Man, my Diet Root Beer has me all having fits here. I don't see where it's at. Well, that's not good, Terry Lynn. All right, we're going to use a different one then. All right, we're going to try this. Hold on. So we're going to go in with this mushroomy looking color. Tap off, and then I always look down so that any fallout goes to the ground and not on my face. Okay, so I really smoked the under eye. Can you see the difference? Smoke,
yes.
No smoke, smoke, no smoke. Now you see why I call it this part, smoke. My smoke in my mirrors. In my mirrors. Okay, mom.
I love it.
Man, it's crazy though. I could walk past you and you would never even know it was me if I didn't have makeup on. It's nuts. Like, you know how sometimes some women, they put on makeup and, you know, they still pretty much look the same or, you know, they look better or just whatever. And then there are people like me that it's like, damn, she really needs that makeup. All right. So now we're going to, I love, 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 I've used this for 25 years, I swear, Luminous Mascara. I don't know why I'm telling you this, and I didn't tell you the other names of the other things, but this is one of those things that I really swear by. So I used to get it in waterproof and non-waterproof, but I found out that if I put waterproof on, pretty much if it ever, like if one lash got stuck to the other lash, it was brutal to separate those two. It's like a bad fight, you know, trying to separate the fight up. Anyway, so this one is called Carbon Black. Like, it's the blackest black you can get. So this is just black, and then this is Carbon Black. So I'm going with the Carbon Black. And I'll do my bottom lashes first. I'll do my top lashes. I won't curl them because I'm going right behind them with a set of these Mamma Jammas. Okay? Guess what, guys? I think I'm going to have lots of time. I'm going to take time to talk. So I know this is going a little bit like longer than normal, but I thank you guys for bearing with me. And yeah, I will make sure I stop after I finish all this and we'll talk. Okay, so bottom lashes. Make sure you don't get your hair in it because that has happened to me a million times. And again, I don't know why we have to. I guess we don't have to open our mouths, but it's almost like it's just this reflex that happens.
You just got a Ninjagini of Rob Robinson.
Rod! You're giving me stuff and I can't even see it.
Rod, yeah, sorry.
Ronnie! Okay. Down here in the South, they say spoilt. I'm spoilt. Thank you, Rodney. Should I sing my song? Come on, baby, drive my car. Yes, Okay, my makeup mirror broke earlier. It didn't break, but it kind of like the ball in the socket, like, you know, like, and so I just decided to leave this out and have it as a microphone. So actually, I'm going to do the suction cup to the table. Watch this. Oh my gosh, this is so exciting. Twist, and now it will stay. Now I can just be like, can I get a cashier on lane 5, please? Cashier on lane 5. And then I can also say, clean up on aisle 8. Ricky, why are you late for work? Please see me in the manager's office. Thank you. I love that. What'd you say? Yes, meet me in the manager's office. That's right. I'll see you there. Okay. But do you see how it sticks to the table? Isn't that awesome? So it sticks to the mirror like that, except this sticks onto it. Okay, it just fell off. It just fell off. All right, hold on, guys. I'm going to stick it again. And
so AJ is asking you, do your eyelashes ever irritate you?
My fake ones or my real ones?
Her fake ones or her real ones, AJ.
Because that's a big difference. Which ones, fake or real?
Because I guess your fake ones.
yeah, they do. So, it's funny, Dakota, when she was little, she used to love to pull off my fake eyelashes. And so if I ever had a show at the Staples Center in LA and I had a red eye home, I would literally like fly home with these daggum things glued to my eyeballs just so that when I got home at 6 a.m, she could rip them off. That's called a mother's love right there. That's called a mother's love. All right, so I just did my bottoms. I haven't done my top yet. I'm going to do my top lashes. I'm not curling them because there's going to be the curl of the fake lash. If I was not using fake lashes, I would use an eyelash curler to make them fan up a little bit. But even when I curl my eyelashes, they're not long enough to make them look the way I want them to. So I use falsies. Okay, so we're going to do the top really fast. And you just want to get to the base of your lash, so that especially if you have light-colored eyes and lashes like me, if you don't get to the base, it's going to look really janky. And, like, even now, sometimes I'll go back and just hit the base so that... when I put the eyelash, okay, I see how it goes in like layers, like see this one compared to that one, and that's not even with a curled lash or anything. So we'll do the other one, and then you can see how that looks, okay? Or should I go ahead and do like a fake lash on this one so you can see like really the difference? Should I do that? Let's do that.
So Derek Jakey said, would you say eyeliner or lashes are more challenging to apply?
Well, because I'm older now and my skin is not as taut on my eyes as it was before, definitely eyeliner. Lashes are a breeze for me. Watch, now that I say that, they'll be a pain in the patookas, but that's not what I wanted. That's what I wanted. Okay, so... Okay, so either with my fingernails or with a little tweezer. God, I can't think of words tonight. Oops. I take and I just kind of do it like this, make sure it's rounded, and then I hold it this way. Now I have to put my glasses on or I can't see how to do this. They came out with this new thing called quick dry glue, and before this you had to sit and blow forever to get your lashes, the lash glue to dry. So this is this new lash glue. And I left it out earlier. Anyway, you just run it along the edge of your lashes. And then with this, you immediately put it on. So, otherwise I would be like blowing on them, but
Actually, I watched a video of you on YouTube, I think, last week. It's from 3 weeks ago. You were getting interviewed with that lady, Jeanette. Your makeup was class.
The cat, when I did her makeup? Is that what you're talking about?
No, you did an interview with a lady.
That was a painful interview, dude.
You killed her. I'm sorry. I was like, she didn't have a clue who you were. I could just see you saying, did you fucking Wikipedia or anything before you interviewed?
Yeah, that was brutal. I tried to be nice, too. I tried to be really nice. Okay.
Oh, you killed her. I was laughing.
Okay, so this is the right eye with bottom mascara, top mascara, and the fake lash on versus my little top lash without any mascara on. And so you guys see the difference. Yes. Wow. I see the difference. Even if you don't, I see the difference. All right, let's get this other side done so we can talk. I'm just going to throw all this in the floor. No, I'm not. I'm not going to do that to my mama. So this dress has a cowl neck to it, but sometimes it doesn't land right, and I don't like that. I have a pair of black and white polka dot shoes that I wear with it. It's kind of a little overkill with the polka dots, but it's okay. It's all right. All right, here we go. Last eyeball. And I did bring my curling iron in here in case I needed to spruce up my hair, but I don't know if I'm going to need to or not. I think I say no, and then us just visit. How's that? Okay, so I'm going to show you guys a problem that I'm having right now and how I have to fix it.
I'll have to get Jimmy to do your makeup if you come over to Ireland.
Yes. That would be so much fun. Okay, let me show you what I did wrong or what I didn't do well. So, over on this eye, close to the lid, right in this section, there's a little tiny gap between my lash line and the actual liner. So, what I'm going to do is find my liner, first of all. Okay. Normally, I would have a black, actually, you know what? Let me see if this is super blue or if this, I can do this. No, I won't do it that way. Normally, I would have a black liquid, but I don't right now, so all I have is a pencil with me. So, I'm going to try, without ruining the lashes, to... SpaghettiOs. Okay. Dirty goes to the right. Okay, I'm going to try and fix that little section right there, where it just...
John 5 just said your hair looks really pretty.
My hair?
Your hair. Sorry. It's why I have a weird accent.
My hair. Thank you, John. I appreciate that, John. Thank you. Now then, I'm going to smudge this again a little bit. Okay, so that fixed that. Now... gotta put a little lash on really fast. And again, I've got to put my glasses on so I can. Did any of you take a screenshot of me without my makeup on at the very beginning? If you did, let me know. I would love to see a side by side. Take the tweezer, grab the lash, take the wrist, break
it. Does this hurt?
Does what hurt?
Putting fake lashes in.
Not in the least. What happened to my Martin?
Probably fell asleep.
Bless him.
Yeah, he's not been on here in a while, has he?
No, he hasn't felt the best lately, bless his bones. Okay, alright, so there we have both sides on. Now, the last thing I'm going to do is my lips. And because I keep pushing my hair back, it looks jank. All right, hang on, guys. Well, have you guys really, like, hung in there with me through this whole darn process? I'm impressed. I'm so impressed.
Yeah. There's 25 people watching, so...
Bless your bones. Bless your bones. Okay, let's see what I want to do here. Oh, no. Okay. I want to do a little liner on my lips. Make them look bigger. So I can look like I got big, juicy lips. There's that little thing that I wanted. What color is that little thing? Oh, sweet Jesus. I think I bought that for Halloween or something. Not going there at all. Alright, so I like to go a little bit outside of my lip. Hang on. Hang on, guys. Hang on.
Derek Jake is asking, do you do blush?
No. I just do bronzer and then diffuse that a little bit. I don't like blush. I don't like to have, like, a color on my cheeks. I just like it to be like it is. Okay, here we go. Lips. That wasn't good, Terry Lynn. What's with my screw-ups tonight? I think it's because I'm nervous and being watched.
I don't be nervous. We're all friends.
There are voyeurs at my party. Alright, so before that dries, I'm going to go in with this little brush and see that line. I'm going to make it not look so... Okay, so we diffused it a little bit, right? Then we're going to do the top, and then we're going to do the same thing again.
John 5 just said he doesn't care for blush either. It gets on his sideburns.
All right, Mr. Smarty Pants. I talked with John last night. It's funny because I was going to immediately be on the phone with John, but Mom was like, the chickens and the dogs and the cats. And so, yeah, I went outside to do all that, and then I came back inside. And I literally was, like, piddle farting around, and I went, oh, John, oh, my God. And then I called him. But I think he thought I was not going to call him because it took me so long to get on the phone.
Oh, wait, really?
Stop it, Liam.
I'm joking.
You guys, you only knew. Poor Liam.
Derek Jake, you said they love my accent. Thanks.
Isn't it nice? I like it, too.
I'm talking really slowly.
Yeah.
Really trying to talk slow.
I can't understand Bert when he talks fast. I can't do it. I'm like, dude, try again. And I have, and then sometimes he'll repeat it several times, and I'll have to say spell it. Like, I can't even get it. Like, I'm so ashamed. It's funny.
It's not, the Scottish accent is so hard.
It is. It really, really is. Okay.
It's like Shrek.
Yes.
Donkey!
Yes, exactly. Mike Myers did such a good job in that movie.
Oh, it's amazing.
Yeah.
It really... Austin Powers when he did Fat Bastard. Oh,
yes.
Scott Bastard as well.
Yeah. So funny. He, and he's what, from Canada, I think, right?
I think he's Canadian, yeah.
Yeah.
What's he doing now? I haven't seen him on TV.
Do you know, I was thinking that the other day. It's been forever since I've seen him do anything. I don't like this color. We're going to have to fix it. I think I'm just going to put a gloss on. I'm just going to the gym. I don't think they're going to look at me like a fruitcake anyway if I've got all this makeup on.
The gym?
Yes, I'm going straight to the gym from here.
How fun. I thought you were going out for dinner or something.
Oh, no. Oh, no. How funny is that?
Club fist, the gym.
And I'm about to jump on and talk with everybody. Hold on. See, eyebrows, okay, so I just keep my, you guys will see, like, I think I did eyebrows once this past weekend, but for the most part, I hate them. Dakota told me, she's like, Mom, you look good without them, so I'm just like, screw it, I'm not putting eyebrows on, so. All right, that's not my best lip, nor my best face, but for those of you who, how many have been here from start to finish? Like, how many of you? And be honest. No BS. Come on, be honest. Didn't put on my top color. Hold on. One last color to put on my eyes. Sorry. All right, how many people were here from the beginning? Are they saying or no?
Rod said he was.
Yeah, I know Rod was. God love Rod, he's here.
I think most of your cigars were here for the start.
Yeah, aw. My sweet subscribers. Oh my gosh, so listen to this. Today, I had to go to the doctor to get, up where Mom lives, I don't have a doctor up here. So I had to go get an inhaler because I've been wheezing a lot. Like, all of the, like the trees and the grasses and stuff have had me very wheezy. And so my inhaler that I have is getting down to like the nitty gritty. And I think I may have like 25 more puffs or something, which right now I'm even tight in my chest. You know, I can barely breathe. Anyway, so I go in and the doctor is giving me all these questions like, do you smoke? Do you vape? Do this? And I'm like going, and I'm thinking to myself, like, how do I answer that? I'm like, no. And she's like, do you vape? And I'm like, no. She goes, have you ever smoked? And I was like, okay, listen, lady, I've got a confession to make. And so, yeah. And I was just, and then she wanted to put me on some other, like, drug that I take every single day. And I'm like, oh, contraire, mon frere, I don't want to do that. I just want an inhaler so that when I can't breathe, I can do the poof, poof, and I can breathe. You know, that's all I want. Hey, guess what, guys? Like it or lump it, this is it. So, now we get to talk. I can put this stuff. Oh, thank you. So, this would be appearance makeup. This is like heavy duty appearance makeup. One day we'll do au naturel and we'll do that kind of makeup, but for this right now it's yeah. Alright, let me put my glasses on so I can see what you guys are saying. Ray Ray, would you like to come over? Can you guys see Ray? Dang, you can't see him. Jesus, why could you see him before and now you can't? Did I have it like this? There we go, Ray Ray. You guys can see the top of his head, right? Alright, I'm just gonna start reading. Okay. Oh gosh, let me look up here. God, let go of the group of the gym. knew you would call that. So, Dan, like, so far, literally, I haven't read or looked at anything that you guys have said because I've been doing my makeup and totally ignoring everything, so I'm just now jumping on. However, if you're also just now jumping on, you know that Liam Paul has been reading what you guys have said and then asking me the questions and letting me answer them that way, so... Derek Jake, if I'm going out dancing, I'll sometimes do a deep red blush contour a la 80s style, but blended so it's not clowny looking. Ha ha. And know how good you look when you go out. I want to go to the saloon. I want to go to the saloon. By the way, I told you guys I brought my other necklace. Okay, so this is what Derek and Jake gave me. You know they gave me the sterling, right? But look at the presentation. Okay, look at the presentation. So every character right there. And then this is my gold version of the same exact necklace. So she double, Marlena, Terry, oops, hold on, Alexandra. Isn't that amazing? So I have, the gold and I have the silver. And I just am so over the moon about them. I don't even know what to do. I like, you know, I run into total strangers and I just say to them, look at my necklace. Just look at it. Just look. Stare at it, please. Just look at it. Yeah, it's crazy. I'm just so proud of it. Everyone that sees it, Derek and Jakey, everyone that sees it says how thoughtful the gift was. And that's so true. It's such a thoughtful gift. All right. Speaking of thoughtful gifts, also, I have not been able to see all of the nice things that you guys have given me. I know Rodney gave me a Ninjagini. What else did I see over here? Let me go back and see. Rodney Robinson Ninjagini. Hey, that might be the only donation of the night.
It was a guy in the derby, wasn't
there? Oh, yeah. Yeah, where did that go?
AJ was the diamond.
I don't see it, though, now. That's crazy. Why did it disappear?
It's a long, long time ago.
I know, but I just went all the way up to the top. I went up to where Liam Paul says, I'm here. Oh, it's before that. I didn't realize it cut off some of the stuff. Wow. You guys, I'm melting into a pool of butter. Okay, there's that. Hold on. Okay, let's start here. AJ, I was here from the start of the tutorial. John Bot, I was 15 minutes late working out. I've been here for 30 minutes. Hi, Mr. K. Kevin. I haven't seen it. I've said hello to you. I was early, but not the beginning. Okay, Toucan Sam. Toucan Sam, I love it. Isn't that from Fruit Loops? Fruit Loops? This sucks. I'm about to have to go turn like some serious freaking AC on in my mother's home, and she's gonna wake up and be like, Terry Lynn? You sure I'm cold in here? Did you mess with the thermostat? Oh my gosh, this is terrible.
Like, no, Mom, I didn't.
Well, and wait, it gets better. I don't know if you guys know what an electric blanket is, but she has an electric blanket and it's on 9, which is one notch before high. So, and it's hot in this house. Oh, my Lord. Help me, Jesus. You guys are awesome. So, what's the workout tonight? Tonight's workout is back and buys. Back and buys. Skelly chew. Isn't that not... Okay, I'm just now getting to where you guys said about how nice the necklace was. Liam Paul, thank you for the lemon. See my lemon face, my lemon sucky face. Thank you, Mr. K. Kevin, for donating a lemon. AJ, I donated a lemon earlier, a diamond earlier. Thank you, AJ. When I scrolled back up, it didn't show that. I guess that was just, I honestly thought, like, it would show me, like, the entire stream. I didn't realize that after a certain time, it would cut it off. I didn't know that. I had to take a break from the cars tonight. No, you're absolutely fine, and I thank you. Toucan Sam, yes. Tony the Tiger over Toucan Sam. Did I like Frosted Flakes over Fruit Loops? No, I like Fruit Loops better, but they're so god-awful for you. I mean, all that stuff's god-awful for you. What time is it? Okay, so I did my makeup. It took me an hour and a half to do it, and that was with me, like, stopping and talking and all kinds of stuff, right? Hey, AJ, Liam, I have an idea. Instead of me putting back on my glasses, you want to keep reading and we'll go out that way?
Yes,
go. I'm going to go a little bit. I'm going to go.
Welcome by is a good choice.
What? Say that again?
back advice is a good choice.
Yes, yes it is. Did I tell you what the little young whippersnapper said in the gym last night, or night before last? Did I tell you guys that?
Was it something like, what are you doing here?
Yeah, no, they were like, oh, we thought we were going to work out by ourselves. And I'm like, yeah, so did I. Little shit. Get out of here. No, and then we ended up chatting the whole night. It was lovely. AJ just wrote something, but I can't see what it is.
Someone find her.
Right? Where are my fans when I need them? Okay. Clean up on aisle 8. Clean up on aisle 8. Okay, what do you guys...
So what's your worst day in the gym? What's your worst body part to work out? What's your hits?
Well, I love the results of legs. It's funny, I keep looking at my phone because that's where you are, Liam. I love the results of leg day, but dang, I hate the next day. Because, like, even, like, going to, like, sit down on the little girl's toilet, the potty, it's like you get halfway down and you're just like, oh, my God. Yeah, it's just brutal. It's brutal. But, yeah.
Leg day is my favorite.
You like leg day. I like the results of leg day. I just don't like that. Like the jello legs of leaving and the, yeah. And, yeah. And I've done something to my right knee, which is not making me happy. I don't think I'm going to be able to do cardio tonight. And that makes me really sad. But I've been eating beautifully. I've been being a very good girl. My mornings have started out with like meaningful things to read or listen to, things that will enrich my life. And that's another little tip trick really quickly. If you do your makeup and you put your hair in a ponytail, then what you also and you've got a different color face than you do rest of your body, you must do your bronzer in here too. And of course, if you have Michael Kors bronzer, it smells just like the perfume, so it's like layering the perfume. So it's lovely. Questions? I'm gonna ask a question of you guys. Wait, I'm gonna ask a question. Who is that? TAM is all I can see.
Your TM Cabril says hello.
Hello.
Dan Edwards says, I'm your number one Terry fan.
Is that different from my number one?
That's debatable, Dan Edwards. That's debatable.
Is that different from my number one Alexander fan or what?
It just says hashtag number one Terry fan.
Oh, thank you. I can see that. Tam, which I don't know the rest of the thing, just followed. Thank you, Tam. What did Derek, Jakey just said something, and AJ and John just said something.
Jakey said abs and butt are his favorite days in the gym.
Abs and what?
Butt, ass.
Oh, arse, the old arse.
The arse, and then John 5, my legs are still sore from 2 days ago, resuming the gym.
Yeah.
AJ, my legs feel like jello the next day.
Yeah. Yeah, but you know what? I got to get my stuff back together, so I'm happy to be doing it again. I really am. It makes me really happy to be back in the gym. Would you guys like to
just say, Tina? He has knee pain from leg extensions, and I changed. Changed what? What did you change, John?
Yeah, you changed into another creature. What? You guys, what is your favorite thing or least favorite thing about going to the grocery store? Everybody has to answer. Favorite and least favorite. Favorite and least favorite.
I hate, what you call it in the States? The trolleys?
We call them buggies, but go ahead.
Buggies. I hate it when they're, do you put, like, dollar coin or coins in to use them?
No, they're free.
They're free. We used to put like a euro coin or a pound coin in.
Stop it!
And then some people over here, they pull the chain across and plug it into itself, so to use a trolley without paying for it, and it annoys me so much.
No.
It bothers me.
Oh wow! I'm surprised you have to pay. I mean, okay, like in some airports you have to pay to get a little buggy thing. But
you get your money back when you finish using it. It's just to use it.
I didn't even know that because I don't ever use them. I mean, I would rather pay a porter to help me than anyway. But yeah, it's funny. I didn't know that you guys called them different names until like I went over there, and then Dakota had nannies from New Zealand and Australia, and you guys have pretty much the same, like, you know, you guys all call them trolleys. Like, you call the countertop in the kitchen a bench, right? Hi there. How are you? I am actually, you are now on my live stream. And, yeah, so, and it just, because you called in, I think I hung up on the person that was actually reading my questions to me because I don't have my glasses on, so they were reading them to me. They're in Ireland, so I'm going to hang up with you, call them back, finish up my live stream, and I'll buzz you back. Okay, bye. That was funny. Let me get Liam back. Call again. I'm sorry, Liam. I'm so sorry, Liam. Did I hang up on you, or did it just automatically hang up on you?
It just automatically hung up on me.
I'm sorry.
Don't worry.
Can everyone see?
Just don't do it again, okay?
Can everyone see your lumberjack red flannel? Love it. I love it. Okay, talk to me. Okay, so you told me about that. I need to hear from other people about the grocery store. What you like, what you don't like. Talk to me.
It's okay, right.
Talk to me.
Let me scroll up. Rob Robinson, he likes free samples. Derek Jakey, favorite is finding new items to try. Least favorite is dealing with people with no spatial awareness. I got you
now. Oh, right.
Skelly Chew, favorite is going through all the aisles and seeing all the delicious food and cool stuff. Least favorite is getting the stuff home.
Oh, yeah, having to lug it in. Yeah.
Derek Jakey also requires a quarter to unlock the cards. Okay.
And you're, where's, really? Well, Florida does not charge for that. So everybody come on down to Florida.
Skelly Chew, putting all the shopping away, are waiting for mom to pick out all the groceries she wants, might take forever. Oh, yeah. Mr. Kevin, favorite equals a small, the smell of food, that's his favorite, and then the least favorite is the long queue.
Yeah.
I can't say his name. Two cans there. Wait. Pulling groceries up to my least. Up to my least favorites.
Okay.
Huh? Putting groceries up, yeah, okay.
Putting groceries up is my least favorite.
What does that mean? In that way, like?
It means, like, that's his least favorite. That is his least favorite. Putting the groceries up. Like, when you get home, and you take them in, and then you have to put my microphone. I just thought it spelled.
I put them away.
Yes.
I put them up.
Yeah, put them up. Yeah.
John 5, my squat is at 315 for max.
John, we're off the gym. We're on grocery stores right now. John, the subject matter is the grocery store. Did you tell
him? He's really 60. He says he's 60 years old.
He looks phenomenal. He really does. Kudos to John.
Is he really 60?
Yeah, have you seen him?
No. 60?
Yeah, you should see. Like, his body looks great. He's done a great job. Yeah. What's next?
AJ, Terry looks like she's about to moderate a debate.
I am. The next question is...
John 5. I look at junk food... stop typing, everyone. Move it. I look at junk food aisles, sees her shopping there, and run the other way.
That's a very good deterrent. Very good deterrent.
AJ, what is my least favourite about groceries, you asked?
Yeah.
Okay. Derek Jakey, have you tried Trader Joe's or Aldi's yet?
Okay, I don't like Aldi's at all, and I love Trader Joe's.
Aldi's in the UK as well.
Aldi is not good over here. It's like cheap over here.
Yeah, it's cheaper over here. It's not like German kind of.
They like don't give you, you have to get your own groceries to the car, and the first time I'd ever been in one, Martin was here, and we went in one together, and Martin took pictures of it and everything, and I was like unimpressed. Like you have to, like they just cut open a box, and then you pick out of the box. I don't know. It was not good.
Yeah, it's the same in the UK.
Okay.
It's the same.
John, I can see where you wrote it in caps. I like the jump.
And he said, thank you, Miss Ones.
My pleasure. You deserve the kudos and the compliments.
AJ, my least favorite about groceries is going to Walmart.
Well, then why do you go to Walmart for groceries, silly goose?
Is Walmart bad?
Well, no, I don't think it's bad. It's just, it's not the... The clientele is not, like, the best clientele. You never know what you're going to see when you go into a Walmart.
Oh, okay, I
got
you.
Yeah.
Okay, trailer trash.
Like, they have websites just specifically for, like, look it up, like, Google it. Like, photos of people in Walmart, and there's, like, websites dedicated to people in Walmart dressed or doing crazy stuff. Yeah. Nuts.
So Skinny Chew, I also enjoy going through the cheap DVD bin when a grocer has one.
I do too.
Me too. I love that. Actually, I miss video shops.
I know, right? The good old days of videos, yeah.
Yeah, actually going to pick out a film.
I know, yeah.
Oh, amazing.
Yeah.
Anyway, Derek JP, they're the same company. Aldi has some good key items, but I prefer Trader Joe's.
I didn't know they were owned by the same people. Wow, cool.
John 5, my gym, is at my home. I got about everything, no waiting.
Yeah. Well, mine is in my storage unit, so there.
Now, Jakey, Walmart is trashy. I don't go often, but it's near me when I need stuff.
Here's what I have to do when I go to the grocery store. If I am hungry, I cannot go grocery shopping because I buy way too much. So I go over to the either the seafood department or the deli. They always have like a shrimp cocktail cooked shrimp, always. Always. And like I'll get a quarter pound of that and then just eat it as I'm shopping with my little wet paper towel to wipe my hands on, you know, as I'm shopping. Or I'll get some meat at the deli, or I'll get like a hot chicken wing, like, or two hot chicken wings, just something to satiate my desperate need for food. And then that way I can slow down and I can shop and it's not so bad. That's my tip and my trick. Guys, hear how like bass I sound and how froggy I sound? That is from me not breathing well and me not sleeping well. I did go to sleep early last night, earlier than I thought I would, AJ and Rodney, but I did wake up middle of the night and wasn't pretty.
But when your voice goes croaky, it's very therapeutic.
For you it is?
Yeah.
I should do an ASMR when it's like that.
But no, honestly, your podcast, and I used to listen to it, sometimes your voice would be croaky or sometimes than others, and I would fall asleep.
That's hilarious.
Yeah,
I find it a nuisance.
Jimmy says the same thing.
Really?
Yeah, you have the most therapeutic voice.
That's too funny. I find it annoying.
No, it's not.
That's funny. That's really cute.
So you should send voice samples online and pictures of your feet and you'll make a fortune.
Let me do this. wait, I think of something good.
So Derek Jenke said, Target's way better. and the headquarters is in Minneapolis.
Ah, I love Target. Has anyone ever been in Dollar Tree? We talked about this with Martin, remember? You guys have Poundland, we have Dollar Tree. I love Dollar Tree. Why is it that I need one thing or want one thing in Dollar Tree and walk out $50 later with 50 items? Why? Why?
It's the same everywhere you go like that. It's amazing. And you don't even need the stuff.
Ooh, we just had some activity out in the country. Did you guys hear the siren? Okay, I would like to talk to you guys seriously for a moment using my microphone. And you know, if I said talk to you seriously, then I'm not being serious. I would like to say that I don't like it when my voice is froggy, and I'm either sick, tired, or in this case, I'm having issues with my breathing. And, what time is it? Can anyone tell me the time? Is it 9?
I don't know.
Someone tell me the time, Eastern Standard Time. Wait, I can look at my phone. What am I thinking?
It's nearly 2 a.m. over here.
Oh my gosh, you guys have to go to sleep. Okay, listen, it's, we'll, 6 more minutes, we'll stop at 9 on the dot. We'll stop at 2 on the dot, your time, Liam.
Okay.
Is that
like,
did you like? Did you say 2 or is it 1:54 or 2:54?
1:54.
Okay, all right. So we'll stop at 2 a.m. your time and 9 my time. Yeah. Whatever anyone's saying.
Okay, so SRB78 says you have nice nails.
Thank you. Do you see that? It has my daughter's name on it.
AJ says, someone there approached me once there to convince me to sign up for Verizon. I told her I'm just here to get batteries.
Where is it?
I presume it's at Walmart.
At Walmart, really? That's interesting.
So, John 5, my God, last year I found an old man passed out on the floor in Walmart. Oh. I helped him up and called 911.
Oh my gosh.
He was okay.
Well, thank God.
AJ Dollar Tree is his dad's favorite. Derek Jakey, Poundland sounds dirty. You got
that's
that
the,
right.
That's the first thing I said, Derek and Jakey, was because Martin's like, oh, we have Poundland. I'm like, okay, that sounds like pornography right there.
Well, in Ireland, Poundland is called Deals. So
Deals.
Yeah, Deals with a Z. And you can actually buy a vibrator for €1.50.
Wow. Can I get a wow on aisle 9, please? A wow on aisle 9, please. Wait a second. Deals. That's another thing you guys do. You don't say a Z, you say Z.
Yes.
And the other thing you guys do that I think is cute and funny is for the letter H, you pronounce it H.
H. Yeah, H.
H. Yeah, H and Z. Yeah, and I will never forget. I was on some like little. It was like a Saturday night live show, but it was on Saturday mornings in the UK, maybe just in England. But it was a skit. It was a skit show like Saturday Night Live over here. And there was a band over in the UK called Steps. Do you remember Steps?
Oh, I know Steps. I love Steps, actually.
Okay. So, the guy that was in the skits with me, his name was H, and they were trying to tell me his name, and they kept saying, his name is H, and I kept trying to, like, again, spell it in my brain so I could pronounce it properly, and finally, they're just like, H, H, just a H. I'm like, oh, H, okay, I got it. But yeah, that was his name. So you know who I'm talking about.
I do.
Yeah.
Apparently the H stands for hyperactive.
Oh my God, he was hilarious. It should stand for hilarious too. Hilarious and hyperactive, yeah. But that was a fun show to do.
But I know, Steps are cool. They did like a comeback tour last year.
Oh, really?
Yeah, just to do all the greatest hits. And
the show I was on had Ant and Deck, and then what was the girl's name? She was little Kat Deeley.
Oh, Kat Deeley, yeah. I don't remember. She's vanished off the face of the earth.
Well, you know, she came over here for a while to do some show.
Right? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and but then I don't know where she's at now. I don't know. I don't know what happened to her.
She must have retired. Anyway.
She retired. All right, guys. We've got 3 minutes.
Are your toenails the same color?
Say that again. Yes, they are. Yes, they are. And I'm not showing them.
AJ says, see, Walmart is troublesome. The real Joker says, hi, Terry.
The real Joker. Hi, but...
The real Joker.
The real Joker, you misspelled my name. Oh, no.
That's the man who is spelling it. It's I.
I'm a girl. I'm a girl.
She's a girl.
I just put on all this makeup to prove I'm a girl.
John 5, we are talking about Pong again? Stop. I'm not prepared for that.
Wait, what is that?
Remember Pong? It was a... Oh.
Remind me, guys.
Oh, sugar. John, what was Pong again? Porn. Remember
what? Porn. Oh, yes. Porn. Yes. Yes, that was a funny night.
William Riedel says Triple H instead of Triple H.
Triple H. Yeah. I will never forget William Riedel saying something about his spindly knobs. I was like, excuse
me. His spindly knobs?
Yeah, he was talking about his legs. His spindly knobs.
Oh.
It's like I've never heard that before in my life. Wait, who's leaving? John, are you leaving? I just saw Rodney say night, John. Sweet dreams.
Who's going? Night, John. John.
Oh, wait, let me see. Can we get a good night, John, on aisle 3? Good night, John, on aisle 3. Thank you. Good night, John.
Oh, there it is. Okay.
Good night, John. Happy dreams, John. Look, I'm never putting this back together again. I'm just gonna have this separate as like a separate. That's all.
You could be the checkout girl for life.
Yes. Yes. The answer is yes. What if this really was a microphone? I would be like killing you guys.
I wish Kmart wasn't dying. What's Kmart?
Oh, with a blue light special. Kmart is basically shutting its doors all over the country. It's a goner.
Is it a shop?
Yeah, I was never, you know, I thought it was like even worse than Walmart. I was never into Kmart. I was into Target and then Walmart. I think Walmart's tried to do better. I think they've tried to do better.
Right. Rob said night, John.
Yeah, we all have to start saying goodnight. What does the real Joker say? I see something, but.
It just says love
and
oops.
No. The real Joker says Shazam.
Oh yeah, Terry, there was another wrestler person after you guys. He trained before I knew the Warrior. He goes by the name Warrior.
You know what? And I was supposed to watch his live stream and I didn't. That was because I had to take my mom back to the doctor today and I went to the doctor today, so I'm sorry. I think his thing was at noon today. I apologize. Good night. Love you too, John. A lot of WWE fans here. Yes. Good thing Dealer Brown didn't get at Walmart. I know. Wasn't that so funny? We laughed. That was, I mean, he was really embarrassed. Like, he was seriously embarrassed. That was so funny. What I miss from the old school stores is the huge toy aisles these used to have. What? Wait, I have a question. Whatever happened to Toys R Us, and why did they go out of business? Like, kids love to go in stores like that and touch and feel and play and, like, make a decision on a toy. You don't want to have to order it online.
They don't mean to go out of business, really?
I think Toys R Us went out of business. Didn't they, guys?
I'm going to have to Google that.
Shut down my town long ago, along with Sears. I miss them now because I go. I know, right?
It's still around. It's still here.
What's way too expensive, SRB? What, Toys R Us was way too expensive? I don't know what you guys are talking about. I'm so lost. Can I get Terry caught up on aisle one? Terry, caught up on aisle one, please. Thank you. How many people wait, here's what I want to know. How many people are working at the store that I am talking to right now? Like, that I'm having people go to different aisles. How many people work at our store, at the live stream store, at the Cigars, Scars, and Superstar store? We need to come up with an answer for that. I'm going to say it's 38 people we have working at Cigars, Scars, and Superstars store. Speaking of which, if you buy a t-shirt from Cigars, Scars, Superstars.com, take a picture of yourself wearing it. You, yes you, get a phone call from yours truly, just like John did last evening. It was a lovely conversation. Yes, it was. Okay.
I have to buy a new one.
Oh, a real joke, you want to be the cashier? Okay, you can. As long as I can work the mic. I need to work the mic.
Can I be the manager that sits in the office all day?
Yes, you can sit in the office. Yes, you can be the manager. Everyone can have a job. Everyone can have a job, okay? Everyone has a job at the store. Right now, Rodney Robinson is the general manager because he's golden tonight. So he, like, you're like, store manager, he's regional manager right now. Liam. John came in second. He's like manager of the a section in the store. And AJ, you are manager of what department would you like to be in charge of tonight, AJ?
Cars, definitely. He deserves the car store.
Do we have cars? We do have cars. We have lemons at our store. We have ice cream at our store. We have cars. And we even have jets at our store. We have t-shirts, lemons, diamonds, ice cream, cars, jets. Is that it? That may be
and
it.
And meat.
And meat? Guys, we have to say goodnight. It's getting very late. I've got to go to the gym. I've got to take this damn dress off and put on some sweats and go to the gym. I like saying my S's like this sometimes. Wait. Toys R Us is expensive, and they don't offer anything that other stores do. Offer anything that other stores do. For the most part, that's why they're going out of business. So they're Toys R Us.
It says on Wikipedia, they just came out of bankruptcy.
You say liberal, I say long. Toucan Sam, can I get someone to bring up two lemons from the produce section, please? Two lemons from the produce section. Thank you. Wait, I need three lemons. Add three lemons to that, please. Our head cashier, the real joker, for some reason, wants to shop while he's working, and he wants three lemons. Oh my gosh. Really? They did a Netflix documentary about it. Wow.
The real joke is asking you, will you ever have a panel?
That sounds like fun. Yes. I say yes. Guys, what time is it? It's 6 minutes after nine. The store closed at nine. All shoppers, please gather anything you have in your carts, trolleys, buggies, or whatever you want to call them. If you've not paid for your cart, trolley, or buggy yet, please put a quarter in the depository. That didn't sound right. And carry all your items to the front. The real joker will be cashing you out. And we do have a security guard on staff outside if you're afraid to walk to your car, as it is nighttime. So, you go to Pilates, I'm going to go to the gym and work out some steel and some iron and all that stuff. All right, listen, I'm going to sing the goodnight song, but first I have to add some root beer. I almost said lemonade. If you ever want me to, like, love you, diet A&W. I really drink too much of it. I really do. Okay, here we go. Ready? Glasses off. Look at you, real joker. Okay. It's going to sound really good tonight because of my throat and my voice. Ready? I don't know if I can do it. Good night. Sleep tight. And pleasant dreams. to you. Here's a wish and a prayer that every dream comes true. And now, until we meet again, adios, au revoir, I'll be the same. Good night. Alright guys, that's it. I love you all. I'm not putting my glasses back on. So, I see you Wednesday. I see you Wednesday, and we're going to have some fun, and we're also going to be able to, you guys are going to be able to apply for different positions at the store. We're going to carry this store thing on because I love it, and I can't ever be without this ever again. Okay. All right. Liam, we would all like to say thank you for you audibly asking the questions while I was applying makeup and while I was not wearing glasses. So thank you for that. Everyone give Liam a big round of applause. And Wednesday night, I will see all of you. Be there, be square. And just remember, when you see someone that looks halfway decent in makeup, they probably don't look that good without it. And you saw that firsthand here tonight. I love you guys. All right, I'm out of here. I'm gonna let Ray say goodnight. Ready? Yeah. Ray, you got a hair on your shoulder. What the world? Ray. Now this can't happen. Hold on. I'm gonna tweeze a hair off of Ray. You guys, is it a chest hair or what is that? What? Oh, we got it. Okay, Ray. Ready? Ready, Ray. Ready? Look straight in the camera, Ray. Straight in the camera. Keep looking, Ray. Keep looking. Keep looking, Ray. Keep looking.